Today I'll be reviewing Boruto episode 13, The Demon Beast Appears. This episode was amazing, easily the best episode of Boruto so far. And that moment when Boruto got in between Mitsuki and Tsumire, and then Kakashi with his purple lightning. And then we see Boruto with his eye, and it kind of looks like he opened like a dimension to another world or something. This episode was great. Like, if you didn't like this episode, I don't know what to say. Like, My Hero Academia had its episode with Todoroki versus Deku, and this is like Boruto's episode. Like, if you don't like this episode, I don't know what to tell you. So in this episode, it was 100% confirmed that the class rep is involved and that she's the culprit. Like, she's the one who's been taking the chakra from people. And we found out that the class rep was entrusted with the Gozu Tenyo. Then the moment we were all waiting for, Kakashi came. He finally showed up. And unlike with Sakura's appearance, he actually said something and had a part in this episode. So in this episode, we find out that Kakashi says back in like his or Lady Tsunade's era as Hokage, there was this like rule implemented so people in the foundation could live without being suspected. So they didn't really do background checks on them so that there would be no like doubt and stuff in the village. And that's the reason they couldn't figure out who Sumire was or that she was suspicious. But come to think of it, Naruto should have been able to figure out who it was because the Nine Tails has the ability to sense like evil thoughts. So I don't know. Anyways, Kakashi also says that he's here and not on vacation because he found traces of Danzo's research and that Danzo's legacy is the Gozu Tenyo. And it's in Tsumire, and it's the gate to open the Niue. And it's like, whenever Danzo is mentioned, it's never anything good. It's always something bad. It's crazy how they bring back Danzo after all this time, too. And Sai is making it his own personal mission to, like, save all the former Foundation members so that they don't have to. So that. Because Naruto saved him, he wants to save them. And so, the first thing Sai does is take out the class rep easily. He literally just appears behind her and chops her, but then she summons the Niue and it starts like wrecking stuff. Meanwhile, Boruto wants to know the truth and Mitsuki like tells him that it's the class rep who's behind it, but he doesn't believe it. And Mitsuki also gets an order to eliminate Tsumire. From all the clues that we have, it has to be Orochimaru. He's literally talking to a snake. That doesn't fit anyone else. The only one else it could possibly be is like Kabuto, and I know it's not Kabuto. So yeah, we're just gonna call him Orochimaru for now, or Mitsuki's brother. Then we switch back over to the Niue destroying the village, and Kakashi and Sai are trying to handle it, and then Kakashi comes and he slashes it with his new purple lightning move, and I'm like, ooh, that's awesome. Like, he can't use his, like, Chidori anymore because the Sharingan is what helped him control it. If you can remember, Minato said he couldn't use it because it was like out of control, so when he got the Sharingan, he was able to control it. But since the Sharingan is gone, he has to create a new lightning style attack, and that's the purple lightning. When we get back to Mitsuki and Boruto, and Mitsuki tells Boruto that they have to kill the class rep, but Boruto doesn't want to. But then Mitsuki asks him who he chooses to save, the village or his fa the village and his family or Sumire. And Boruto says both, and Mitsuki's like, I wouldn't have thought of something like that. And he wants to like know more about Boruto and discuss like their differences and stuff like that. So then Mitsuki makes a shadow, like a snake clone, to hold Boruto while he goes to carry out his orders. Boruto manages to break free with his shadow clones. He just uses the gentle fist to just hit himself in the face. Basically, he's just like, do it, and then he breaks himself free. That's the most Naruto-esque strategy I can possibly think of. Anyways, I love how when Naruto comes and he's like, I'll end this with one move, but then Sai's like, no, you can't because it absorbs chakra. Now, if this was Naruto or Naruto Shippuden, there'd be a simple solution to this problem, and that would be known as the Rasengan. But I don't see Naruto using it for some reason. I love how Kakashi took control of the situation like he was the Hokage. He just orders Naruto. He's like, Naruto, go help the barrier core. Because that's like the only thing Naruto can use his chakra for at the moment. The outskirts of the village, we see the class rep who's watching, wondering what she should do, like if she should explode the Nue now or wait. And then Mitsuki comes out of nowhere and strikes ready to kill. Mitsuki's always ready. And the reason he found her is because he put a snake on her while he went to visit her in the hospital. Mitsuki's could already be an Anbu, like he's that ready and that strong. We've already seen what he can do. Like in his second appear, like in the second his second episode appearance, he was already proven to be strong. And if you know his origins, like that's even more of a reason to know that he's already ready to become like a full-fledged ninja. He doesn't need the academy at all. So Mitsuki gets her down with her neck under his knee easily, but then Boruto comes and she gets away. Like she hasn't really been able to do much. Sai, I wish it was Sasuke. Sai chopped her down easily, but then she summoned the Nue out of her back, and then Mitsuki stops her easily, and Boruto basically comes and saves her. And she tells Boruto that her plan was to destroy the Hidden Leaf, and that the reason she was born was for revenge, and that she had to live to do what her father couldn't. So Mitsuki is like, I knew it would turn out like this. He sighs, he's like, I knew it would turn out like this. And then he's just walking over to Sumire ready to get her. But and then he also tells Boruto that he would regret coming because he plans on killing Sumire. But then as he's going for the kill, Boruto stops them and gets in between them. Then his eye turns on and he's like, cut it out. And I'm like, oh, Boruto, I didn't know he was this good. Then his right eye starts going crazy and starts shooting lightning. And over on the battlefield, the Nue gets sucked in, he gets sucked into, like, this black hole, like, with the Kamui. And I'm like, whoa, is this Boruto? No. And then the class rep gets this evil look on her face. And then tells the monster to, like, take her chakra, and then it, like, eats her with its tail. And then Boruto follows after, and Mitsuki gets sucked into the black hole, and then the episode ends. That cliffhanger was, oh, crazy. I was like, where's the rest of the episode? So this episode is easily the best episode of the season so far. 11 out of 10. Okay, nah. The first step half of the episode, kind of like, if you knew about, like, if you figured out who it was, then the first half of the episode wasn't all that surprising for you, or wasn't gonna be all that exciting. But if you didn't know who it was, the first half of the episode, well, the entire episode was amazing. Those are my thoughts on this week's episode. Let me know what you guys thought in the comment section below. Be sure to like the video and share. Today I'll be reviewing Boruto episode 14, The Path Boruto Can See. So this episode was like the end of the ghost incident, and we found out a little bit more about the class rep. There were a couple of other things I noticed while I was watching this episode too, but I'll get into those as I'm reviewing. So in the beginning of the episode, Kakashi explains that the summoning animals usually all live in their world, but somewhere far away. I remember Jiraiya mentioned back in Naruto that it would take Naruto 30 days to get to Mount Myōboku on foot. But he says that the Nue lives in like another dimension altogether. So Naruto isn't able to find it even with using his sage eyes. It was cool to see him use his sage eyes. It's like he can just turn them on now. Like it's his own visual jutsu. And Naruto and Kakashi are worried because they consider it like a bomb that they can't track. Well, that's what they're calling it. If Sasuke was here, he'd probably be able to find it because he can like use his Sharingan to get to other dimensions. I'm not exactly sure how he can do it, but we saw him do it in Boruto, the movie. Anyways, at one of the crime scenes, we see Shikadai and Denki and Inojin wondering where Boruto is because he's like always around where there's trouble. Meanwhile, Boruto falls into like the other dimension and starts fighting the Nue, saying he'll avenge the class rep, but Mitsuki comes and he's like, you can't avenge her if she's not dead or whatever. And he says that she's controlling him, but Boruto doesn't really wanna hear that. He's just happy that she's alive, and I'm like, come on. So after Mitsuki and Boruto stop like the Nue, Mitsuki says that his eye is amazing. Which is true because he can like see chakra points now. We didn't know he could. Well, we probably could have assumed that he could see it before, but he wasn't shown seeing like a person's chakra flow before. It was cool to finally see him do that. Oh, and before Mitsuki can finish off the Nue with his like lightning snake, the class rep stops him, and Mitsuki asks if she'll come back, like just for like Boruto's sake. So then Boruto asks, and she points out that she attacked the leaf, and she says that her father was treated like a criminal after the war because he was in the foundation. And to me, it kind of just sounds like Itachi's story. Well, Sasuke, it's like Naruto arguing with Sasuke about how Itachi was the hero of the village, but nobody really appreciated him. But like, it's like a retelling of that story. Not to mention the fact that she says she wants revenge. Like that's just the icing on the cake for me. Boruto says it has nothing to do with her. But she argues that she only existed for revenge, and that she was raised as a weapon, and she also says that her mom died of illness because of all of this. So then she starts attacking, and Mitsuki and her like kind of battle again, and she has like her own attack, well, her own signature move, I guess, and it's named after like her name. And Mitsuki just counters with his like wind scythe jutsu, and I'm like, how good is he actually? How many jutsus does he know? It's pretty cool that he knows like lightning and wind style. So he could probably train under like Naruto or Sasuke. That's pretty cool. Anyways, he also says that he's after the Gozu Tenyo and that he'll take her dead if he has to. I'm like, dang, Mitsuki's savage. I wonder if Orochimaru sent him on a mission to get it. From the last episode that he sent him to like capture her. But I'm not sure why Orochimaru would want the Gozu Tenyo, unless he wants to like study it and create his own. But it's Orochimaru, so who knows? Anyways, Boruto jumps in between Mitsuki and the class rep again, and this time she stabs him in the arm. And Boruto is still trying to defend her, and Mitsuki keeps telling him that she's only using them to get like information. But Boruto refuses like to believe it. But then Mitsuki remembers when he went to see her in the hospital, she said she wanted it to be over as soon as possible. Then Boruto figures out why the ghosts only possess people who are burdened, and that's because it's easier to get a hold of people with like the same mindset as like Tsurime because she's been like struggling herself. He also figures out that it disappears when someone's heart is like affected in a big way. So when she tries to command it, it doesn't listen to her. And Boruto asks, well, he points out that the Nue treats her like a parent, and Boruto asks her if he's just gonna use the Nue as a bomb, even though it treats her like a parent, like what her parents did to her. Boruto tells her to pick her own path. Then the Gozu Tenyo breaks, causing the cave to like break down and cave in because like the chakras went running wild inside. So then they meet on the Nue's back and escape. The Nue goes back and then tries to like save them or whatever. Anyways, then when they get outside, they meet with Shikadai and the others, and then Sai shows up and offers the class rep her help and says that he was once in like the same position. He also says she won't be punished because of ghosts of the past. You also see that the Nue is fine because Boruto notices its chakra floating into like her left hand, and then she leaves with Sai. Then they also realize that it's the morning time, and so they all catch like the first train home. Poor Boruto and Shikadai, you already know they're getting in trouble. And the episode ends. So it looks like we won't be having any more of the ghost incidents. Like they won't be spamming like random ghost incidents within the next episode, so that's nice. I wonder what the new arc is going to be about. So after the next episode, it's officially over, the Ghost Incident arc, if that's what we're calling it. Oh, and by the way, they had a new ending theme song. It's pretty good. I hope they like changed the scenes, like what they did with the last Naruto ending theme song. And also hope Naruto Gaiden is next and Chapter 700 gets animated, because I'm really looking forward to those. Aside from the fact that this kind of felt like a Sasuke and Naruto argument about like Itachi and how he saved the village, I think this episode was pretty good overall. In the next episode, we're gonna find out what happens to the class rep because she kind of like wrecked a small part of the village and caused people to lose chakra. So I wonder if they'll just put her in like the Black Ops or something. That'd be cool. Anyways, that's all I have for this review. Be sure to like and share the video. Thanks for watching and bye.